Are you all ready for our today's class, students? What did we learn in our previous class? We have learned a beautiful poem. What is the title of that poem? The Summer Day, isn't it? Is that interesting? Did you all read the text, read the poem once again? Okay, very good. Students, in this class, let's learn about conjunctions. What is meant by junction? Junction means the joining part of two or three roads, right? Similarly, in grammar, we have three types of conjunctions. Okay? Joining words. Conjunction means joining words. Are you all ready for our today's class? Okay. First, let me tell you what is meant by conjunction. Conjunction are words which are joining two words or sentences or clause. Okay. Now, let me write an example. My name is Sachin. Studying in grade 5. Okay. My name is Sachin. Is this a complete sentence? Yes. This is a simple sentence. Now, I am studying in grade 5. This is also a sentence. This is sentence number 1. This is sentence number 2. These are all two individual simple sentences. Do you know the types of sentences? Simple, compound and complex. So these are simple sentences, right? This is an individual simple sentence. This is a sentence. It has its complete meaning. This is also a complete sentence. And my name is Sachin. My name is Sachin is the sentence. And studying in grade 5 is also a sentence. These are all two sentences. Now, what is this relation between conjunction? Why she is writing all these? Because now we are going to join these two sentences. These two sentences are joined by a word, and that word is called as conjunction. Okay? So this is a sentence. This is another sentence. We are going to join these two sentences by using a word, and that particular word is called as conjunction. What is the suitable word for adding or for joining these two sentences? If I say the word but, okay, is it suitable for these two or adding or joining these two sentences? My name is Sachin, but I am studying in grade 5. Is it possible? Is it the right word to add these two sentences? No, this is wrong. Here we can add and. Right? Now, I am introducing myself to somebody. So, I am saying that my name is Sachin and I am studying in grade 5. So, here the joining word is and. My name is Sachin and I am studying in grade 5 or grade 6. My name is Sachin and I am an engineer. My name is Sachin and I am a doctor. Okay? So here, these are two simple sentences and these two simple sentences are joined by a word. And these kinds of words which are joining two words are called two sentences or two words or a group of words is called as conjunction. Is that clear, students? What is meant by conjunction? Conjunction are nothing but words or a word which is joining two group of sentences or two sentences or two clause or two words. Okay? And one more thing. These conjunctions are, especially there are three kinds of conjunctions, right? Let's see what are the three types. types or three kinds of conjunction. Students, this conjunction, these joining words, this conjunction is divided into three kinds. Okay, they are coordinating conjunction, correlative conjunction, and subordinating conjunction. Coordinating, correlative, and subordinating conjunction. Okay, what are the three types or three kinds of conjunctions? Coordinating, correlative, and subordinating. In your textbook, they have given coordinating conjunction and subordinating conjunction. Let's see what are they, okay, and how it works in a sentence. Are you all taking the running notes, students? Very good. What are the three kinds of conjunctions? Coordinating, correlative, and subordinating conjunctions. Is that clear? Now, first let's see coordinating conjunction. Coordinating conjunctions are words which are joining phrases or words or two independent sentences. What is meant by independent sentences? Just before we have seen that I'm Sachin or my name is Sachin, I'm studying in grade 5. My name is Sachin is an independent sentence, right? It stands on its own. If I say this phrase, it is incomplete. But I am Sachin or my name is Sachin is a complete sentence. It is an independent sentence. In the same way, I am studying in grade 5 is also an independent sentence. So to join these two independent sentences, we are using coordinating conjunctions. And, but, or, it, so, nor. These are the coordinating conjunctions. Okay, mainly we use and, but, or, it. Okay, now let me write an example. I like ice cream. This is a sentence. This is an independent sentence, right? This is a complete sentence. It stands on its own. I like ice cream. Next. I like mangoes. I like ice cream. I like mangoes. These are two independent sentences. Now, we are going to join coordinating conjunctions or joining words. These words are joining two independent sentences. So, here we are going to join two independent sentences. This sentence is not depending on another sentence. This sentence is not depending on this sentence. Am I right? So these two sentences are independent. I like ice cream. I like mangoes. So these two are independent sentences. Now we are going to join these two sentences by adding, by using a word that is called as coordinating conjunction. We are going to add the and. Okay, by using this word and, by using this coordinating conjunction, we can join these two words. Now, how can we write? I like ice cream and mangoes. Here, we join these two sentences. I like ice cream, I like mangoes. So we are joining these two words by using a coordinating conjunction. Coordinating conjunction will join two independent sentences or phrase. Okay, here I like ice cream and mangoes. So now we have joined two sentences, right? Okay, now let me write another example by using the coordinating conjunction but. This and we are using for addition. We are adding two equally important things and both are similar. I like ice cream. I like mangoes. So I love to eat these two things. Right. Now, and that's why we are adding and. I don't like mangoes. These are again two independent sentences. I like ice cream. Okay, I like ice cream. This is a positive sentence. Next, I don't like mangoes. This is another sentence, but the thing is different. The meaning differs. I like ice cream, but I don't like mangoes. Is it same? Can we say I like ice cream and mangoes? No. Why? Because here in the sentence we can see a negative word. I don't like mangoes. So we cannot combine these two words by using and. Instead of and, what we can use? We can use but. Tell me, I like ice cream, but, very good, but I don't like, but I don't like mangoes. Is that clear? I like ice cream, but here these two statements are in contrast. It is not giving the same meaning or there is no similarity between these two sentences. If I write I like ice cream, I like mangoes, there is a similarity. We can add these two sentences by using and. But now I like ice cream, I don't like mangoes. So these are two opposite statements. So they are in contrast. They are not matching. They are in two opposite sides. So to add these two contrast statements, we are using the word but. I like ice cream, but I don't like mangoes. Is that clear, students? Now look at these sentences. I finished my work. I did not attend the party. I finished my work. This is a simple sentence. Students, one important thing. To join two simple sentences, we are using coordinating conjunctions, right? By using this coordinating conjunction, we are changing the simple sentence into compound sentence. So to convert a simple sentence into a compound sentence, we are using coordinating conjunction, right? Now, I finished my work. This is a simple sentence. Again, I did not attend the party. This is also a simple statement, simple sentence. So this is a simple sentence. Again, the next, I did not attend the party, is also a simple sentence. Now, we are going to change or convert or transform these two simple sentences into compound sentence. Simple sentence into a compound sentence. So to convert a simple sentence into a compound sentence, we need coordinating conjunctions. Okay? Keep it in your mind. Coordinating conjunctions are joining words. So these joining words are helping us to transform, to convert a simple sentence into a compound sentence. In the same way, subordinating conjunctions are helping us to transform a simple sentence into a complex sentence. Now let's see how to convert these two simple sentences into a compound sentence by using coordinating conjunction. I finished my work. I have completed my work. This is a sentence. I did not attend the party. I did not attend the party. So, what coordinating conjunction we can use here? I finished my work, but I did not attend the party. We can use either but or it. Okay, so I finished my work. I finished my work is a simple sentence. Now we are using a coordinating conjunction but, or we can use it. I did not attend the party. Okay, I finished my work. I did not attend the party. These are two independent sentences, and we are using a coordinating conjunction here. We can use but or it. Yet, I did not attend the party. Now, we have joined two simple sentences, and now we have formed a compound sentence. How can we find out whether this is a compound sentence? A compound sentence must have a coordinating conjunction like and, it, but, so, or, but also, and so. So these are coordinating conjunctions. By looking at a sentence, if you find these words, these coordinating conjunctions, you can immediately say that this is a compound sentence. In this sentence, can you find any coordinating conjunction? I finished my work, or I like ice cream, I like mangoes. We cannot find any coordinating conjunction there, any joining words there. But in a compound sentence, we can find a coordinating conjunction. We can find a joining word. We can find two independent sentences in a compound sentence. Okay? This is a simple sentence. This is also a simple sentence. But in a compound sentence, we can find two independent sentences. Students, keep in mind, this is a simple sentence. This is also another simple sentence. To join these two simple sentences, we are using a coordinating conjunction. We are using joining words. And thus, these simple sentences are transformed or converted into a compound sentence. In a compound sentence, we can find two independent sentences or two simple sentences. Why? Because we are joining two simple sentences by a coordinating conjunction to form a compound sentence. So obviously, in a compound sentence, we can find two simple sentences. Like, here this is a compound sentence. How can we find this is a compound sentence? Because here we are using, we have used a conjunction. We have used a joining word. Right? So this is a compound sentence. Next, in this sentence, we can find two simple sentences. What are they? I finished my work. This is a sentence. This is a simple sentence. Again, I did not attend the party. This is also a simple sentence. So these two simple sentences are joined by a coordinating conjunction, but. We can use but, and, it, or, nor, and also. It depends on the sentences. Okay? So, these are simple sentences. To join these simple sentences, we are using coordinating conjunction. And if we are using coordinating conjunction, then it is called as a compound sentence. Alright? Now, take page number 81. Take page number 81. Did you all take page number 81? Okay. Coordinating conjunctions. Can you underline the conjunctions in these sentences? You are going to underline the coordinating conjunctions here. I forgot my umbrella at home and it started raining on the way. Underline the coordinating conjunction here. Very good. And is the coordinating conjunction. I forgot my umbrella at home is a simple sentence. It started raining on the way is also a simple sentence. They have joined these two simple sentences by using a coordinating conjunction and. Okay. And now it is a compound sentence. Next. Juhi woke up late but still reached school on time. Juhi woke up late is a simple sentence. She reached school on time is another simple sentence. These two sentences are joined by a coordinating conjunction but still. Okay. Next. He is the tallest boy in the class, yet he wasn't able to get on the basketball team. Here, he is the tallest boy in the class. He was not able to get on the basketball team. So these are two independent, two simple sentences, and these two sentences were joined by it, the coordinating conjunction. Now it is a compound sentence. Now look at the highlighted sentence. A coordinating conjunction joins words, phrases, sentences, or two independent statements of equal importance. Coordinating conjunctions are joining two simple sentences, and these two simple sentences are equally important. I finished my work is a sentence. It has its own importance. In the same way, I did not attend the party. This is also, here also we have to give importance. So these two are two important sentences, and we are joining these two by using a coordinating conjunction. Is that clear? Now, look at question number 3. Choose the correct coordinating conjunction and fill in the blanks. One has been done for you. Students, you can try this. Okay? Next, question number 4. Join the sentences with coordinating conjunctions. One has been done for you. Riddhi has never told a lie. She has never been unkind to anyone. So these are two simple sentences, and they have joined by using she has never told a lie, nor has she ever been unkind. They have used nor as the coordinating conjunction here. Students, the rest of the exercise you can do it by your own. I hope you all have understood what is meant by conjunction and what is meant by coordinating conjunction. Conjunctions are nothing but joining words. Coordinating conjunctions are used to transform two simple sentences into a compound sentence. Okay? So, to convert a simple sentence into compound sentence, we are using coordinating conjunction. And, but, it, nor, and so, these are the coordinating conjunctions. Alright, that's all for today's class, students. See you all in the next class. Until, take care. Thank you.